So, good morning, everyone.
Good morning.
Po sa inyo lahat. This morning po, yung message will be focused on parenting. But specifically po, not only yung pong natural parenting, but yung pong spiritual parenting. All of us na nakakilala na kay Jesus Christ have a right and a responsibility to be able to extend the good news of Jesus Christ to everyone we meet, most especially po yung ating sariling family members who see us, who talk to us, who's able to interact with us as often as we see them. So ito pong message will be focused on that aspect. Yung pong paano po tayo nagiging magulang, hindi lang bilang natural na magulang, hindi bilang isang spiritual na magulang, especially for our little children. Ilan po ba yung ating little children dito sa ating local church? Have you met some of them, or have you welcomed some of them? And you know, there will be a very, very big bearing on the lives of these young people when they recall how we took care of them. Yung title po ng message is Kingdom Parenting. Again, this is in reference to the Kingdom of God now. And yung parenting po in reference to natural parents like some of us, but also to spiritual parenting like Paul was to Timothy. When we say parenting, as natural parents, we say that we have been the source, or we have been the cause of these little sons and daughters that came from our flesh. Pero when we say spiritual parenting, it's likewise similar in the sense na all of us who became believers become also the instrument or the source through which Jesus Christ is given, is shown, and eventually lived by the people that we are able to interact with. So, ano po naman yung mga characteristics ng mga people that some of us interact with? Like in my case, yung mga anak ko po, the children, I found some of them this morning teasing each other until a fight erupts and the household is in darkness. They po po ang brown out pag yung mga bata ay nag-aaway. They're either nagdidilim po ang kanilang mga paningin, o kami mga parents parang nagdidilim din ang mga paningin. So nagkakaroon ng tulakan, nagkakaroon ng parang iwanan kita, ikaw na lang mag-isa maglaro. And yung hindi pagiging mabait sa isa't isa, and children claiming that they're just having fun. Okay, yung nag-aaway-aaway sila, tapos maya-maya pag pinausap namin, nagkukulad-yaan lang naman kami, nagkakagawa lang. E teka, nagkakasakitan na kayo, but you're still having fun. So, as parents, we feel stress. And of course, sometimes we wonder, ano bang gagawin natin in the light of what the Bible is telling us. Now for you, with little children, siguro ganito rin ang nangyayari. Buti pa yung mga lolo at mga lola. May na-interview akong isang lolo, sabi niya, mas masarap daw pag mga apo na. Kasi ang yung tubo na, yung investment nila in having children, and then nagkaroon ng children yung children nila, it's like having an investment na kumita na. And having the grandchildren around, of course, helps the grandparents live their lives in a more... nagkakaroon ng love, nagkakaroon ng bonding, nagkakaroon ng peace. You know, merong chemistry that happens when little children are around to be hugged, to be embraced. Pero syempre, mga lolo tola, pagka medyo nabilibot na yung grandchildren nila, o ite-turn over na dun sa mga parents. So parents, tuloy ang inyong stress, manage it, learn from it, and there are lessons to be learned. And ito nga yung nangyari kay Paul when he was visited by Epaphras. Epaphras became a disciple, he believed Jesus Christ, coming from Colossae, a place where he was able to share the gospel, and many believed and became, these believers became a church. As a background, ito pong babasahin natin sa Colossians. Colossians is a letter written by Paul to oppose false teachers who were telling the people that Christians need to worship angels and to follow special rules and regulations. Paul rather reminds the Colossians that Jesus is supreme over everything, that his death is all that is needed. His death is all we need to save us from our sins. And that through Jesus, we are free from man-made rules. The verse we will be focusing on today is Colossians chapter 1 and verse 13. If you have your Bibles and if you have your notebooks, you might want to write down some of the things that the Holy Spirit will be inspiring you today. Now, when the Holy Spirit inspires us, each one of us is given a special message. And pagbulay-bulayan po natin yung message na yon, because it is specially made for you. If you write it down, if you apply it, if you even teach it to others, then it will come to life. Dito po sa 1 Corinthians chapter 1, verse 13, this is what we find. So turn with me to your Bibles. Kung di naman, you can watch it, proceed in the screen. Ito po yung sinasabi sa 1 Corinthians chapter 1, verse 13. For he has rescued us from the dominion of darkness and brought us into the kingdom of the Son he loves. Yun lang po yung sinasabi dyan. Basahin kaya natin sa wikang Pilipino. Sa wikang Pilipino, sa ang salita ng Diyos, Tagalog translation, this is what we find. Colossas, kabanata 1, talata 13. Iniligtas niya tayo mula sa kapangyarihan ng kadiliman at inilipat tayo sa kaharian ng minamahal niyang anak. Manalangin po tayo. Father God in heaven, we praise and worship you. Father, thank you for gathering us once again to hear your words, to be able to learn your words, and to be able to apply your words. Father, you have forgiven us our sins. And if we have sinned recently, we ask for your forgiveness. And Father, we now ask for your inspiration and blessing upon the message that you have for us today. Protect us from the evil one. And be able to bring us, Father, to the next level of spirituality. The next level of being able to practice and to be able to follow the way of love that you have intended for us through your Son, Jesus Christ. So, Father, we ask all this in the name of your Son, our Savior and Lord. Amen. Now let's read again part of Colossians chapter 1 verse 13. Ang sabi po dito, for he has rescued us from the dominion of darkness. Sino itong binabanggit na he? Si Jesus Christ? God the Father? God the Holy Spirit? Perhaps? If we're going to see the prior verse, ito po yung sinasabi sa Colossians chapter 1 verse 13. Prior to that, verse 12, giving thanks to the Father who has qualified you to share in the inheritance of the saints in the kingdom of light, for He has rescued us from the dominion of darkness. So yung God the Father po yung binabanggit dito. And to be able to do the rescuing, meaning yung pagliligtas, iniligtas, He had to love us. Siyempre, i-rescue mo ba yung hindi makakilala, baka magalit pa sa'yo. God knew us from the beginning. In fact, even before He made the world, He already loved each one of us and chose us. So, could you imagine something like that happening na hindi niya pa-kinitrate ang, let's just say, the planet Earth or even the universe. He already loved us and He chose us. And so when something happened, yung pong fall na tinatawag natin when Adam and Eve disobeyed God, and therefore they suffered the consequence of that choice, meaning they died. They did not die physically immediately. They did not. Yung emotions po nila did not die immediately. But what died was the spirit in man. Namatay po ang spirit ng tao. And you know, God is spirit. The Holy Spirit is spirit. God the Father is spirit. And the only way man can be able to connect to spirit is to be spiritual also. Kaya lang, namatay yung spirit in man. And so God has to prove His love for us by sending His only Son, Jesus Christ, to be our substitute and representative. Substitute because may penalty nga dun sa sin, kamatayan. But of course, Jesus Christ, being fully God and fully human, meaning impact sa Kanya yung pagiging divine niya when He came here. He came here to save us, ang tawag natin kay Jesus Christ, Savior. But He was sent by that Savior who is also God the Father to save us. And because He was made to become like one of us, to be human, therefore we saw Him as physical. In fact, siya po yung physical manifestation ng invisible God. He is the visible God versus yung pong invisible God, the Father and the Holy Spirit. That's why Jesus Christ said, when you see me, Jesus Christ, you have also seen the Father and you have also seen the Holy Spirit. And so, in this context, Jesus Christ was fully alive when He came here. Fully alive physically, fully alive as far as the soul is concerned, meaning your emotions, your intellect, your feelings, and then fully alive spiritually. And therefore, He is able to save us, to save us to become like Him, to die like Him spiritually, to be raised up again like Him spiritually, but also to now sit at the right hand of God the Father spiritually. So to be rescued means to be rescued in full. Hindi lang po yung physical, hindi lang yung soul, but also, most importantly, the spirit. Because when man lost the spirit, he became a property of the dominion of darkness. He became a slave. All of us became slaves of darkness. Now, this is referring to this dominion of darkness, none other than the dark power of Satan or yung kapangyarihan ng kadiliman. Now, to become a slave of Satan is to be in the dark. So, slave ka, sumusunod ka lang, pero saan papunta ang iyong pagsunod kundi sa kapahamakan? Because a long, long time ago, God is already proclaimed judgment. Inurse niya na si Satan that eventually you will go into the bottomless pit. And all of us, prior to the coming of Jesus Christ, were destined to go to that bottomless pit. But now here Paul is telling us, meaning the believers, that God, the Father, has rescued us from this darkness, from Satan, and therefore we are no longer in that stage of groaning as if, ano ba yung feeling mong nalulunot? Okay? One time, I felt that feeling kasi nga, nung elementary student ako, we went on a field trip, so it's a swimming pool, and I don't know how to swim. So, nag-isip nga ako eh, buti pa yung crush ko sa school, marunong lumangoy. Kaya tuloy, during that time, nag-aspire ako na I want to learn swimming. Siguro, sa lakas ng loob ko during that time, na medyo magpakita ang gilas na marunong rin ako, eh, pumunta ako dun sa malalim-lalim. Eh, walang ano-ano eh, teka, wala na ako tinutungtungan dito ah. Maya-maya, nalulunod na ako. Eh, thankfully, yung school teacher namin, inabot yung kanyang paa. Oh, inahata ko yung paa niya, nasagip pa ko. I got rescued. So in the same way, God reached out to us. We are not capable of saving ourselves. It is only when we realize that we were helpless until help was given to us that we are able to go forward. Without that help, we are going backward. And even today, ganun po yung sense that this verse is giving us. And I hope it's giving us hope that we were rescued. And so let's give thanks to God. Let's be thankful to God for this first aspect of what this verse is telling us. Pero nirescue nga tayo, saan naman tayo dinala? And that's what we find in the next part of this verse. Let's continue reading. So continuing in reading Colossians chapter 1, verse 13. Sabi po dito, and brought us into the kingdom. Brought us into the kingdom. In other translations, ang sabi po ay, we were translated from one place to another. But in the NIV, this is how it is rendered, meaning brought us. Mas malapit po siguro sa wikang Pilipino, because this word, the brought us, was translated into inilipat. Inilipat. And this is really what happened to us. Inilipat tayo mula sa kadiliman, napunta tayo sa maliwanag. Like little children, gano'n naman ang kanilang experience when growing up. Diba? Pagka little children, medyo aware na kung ano yung madilim. Medyo nakuwentuhan ng kung sino na dyan sa madilim, marami niyang mga nakakatakot, may mga kung ano-ano dyan. Eh, nag-uumpisa na silang magkaroon ng emotion of fear. And they become afraid of the dark. I mean, any child, pag dinuwentuhan niya na nakakatakot, they learn to fear. And for some of us, syempre, bilang bata, lumaki tayo sa ganong concept na madilim, nakakatakot. So, punta tayo sa liwanag. Or bigyan tayo ng liwanag. Ilipat tayo mula sa madilim na lugar, dalhin tayo dun sa maliwanag na lugar. Because that's when we are able to find ourselves, that we know that we have companions, that we know that hindi tayo nag-iisa. In the dark, nag-iisa tayo. But sabi nga, when we light the candle, then you find out na hindi ka pala nag-iisa. And when others light that candle, yung dalawa na kayo, tatlo na kayo, apat na kayo, until such a time na even with the help of these small candles, lumiliwanag po yung ating paligid. So until we were transferred into this kingdom of light, sinasabi nga sa verse 12, we were lost in the kingdom of darkness. And until light was given us to follow the way to God's kingdom, then it's as if we are as good as hopeless. Hindi tayo makakalabas doon sa madilim na kuweba until somebody gives us the light, until somebody shows us the way out of that cave na madilim, and therefore, we were also helpless. But then, let's continue reading. Because, nilipat na tayo dito sa kingdom. But what is this kingdom like? Para bang, pupunta tayo dun sa isang amusement park. Okay? Nandun na tayo sa highway. Naghihintay tayo dun sa biyahe na matapos na. Then mamaya-maya, nandun na tayo sa parking space. Sabi natin, nandito tayo sa parking space. Tuwan-tuwa na tayo, nakarating na tayo doon sa amusement park na pupuntahan natin na we've heard marami itong rides, marami itong mga fun activities, marami tayong makikita doon kakaiba. Eh doon pa nga lang sa parking space, nung makita mo yung facade. Aba, ang ganda ng facade, nag-picture taking na kayo, buha na kayo ng souvenir, no? Picture taking left and right. Of course, nakakalungkot naman after mag-picture taking, uuwi na lang ba kayo? Na hindi man lang kayo nakapasok dun sa amusement park. But the children are excited to be able to go inside. And you know, for all of us here, we're all hoping, we're all excited to really see what this kingdom is like. Ano bang meron dyan sa loob niyan? Okay, we hear, merong eternal life. No more crying, no more dying, hindi na tayo magugutom. Kasama na natin yung Panginoong Ama. All these things that we cannot even just begin to imagine will be there. Pero really, what is the way to convince us that something invisible is what is worth going after? That this something that is invisible to our eyes right now is worth dying for, like what Jesus Christ did for all of us. What's there in that kingdom? Let's continue reading. And partly this is what we read in the last words of this verse, into the kingdom of the Son He loves. Ito po yung key dito. The Son He loves. Paano ba magmahal ang Ama sa kanyang anak? For some of us with little children, paano ba tayo magmahal sa ating mga maliliit na anak? Di ba, we want to give them the best opportunities. We want to feed them the best food that we can possibly afford. We want to dress them up with the best clothes that we can possibly give them. We want to put a roof over their heads as much as we can afford. Kung pwede, may swimming pool, may tennis court, may basketball court, may football field. May lumalagpas na. Pero I know for some of us who can afford so much, they really want to give the best to their children. But then, this is what we find here. The Father loves His Son so much. And that He is giving all creation to the Son. In fact, creation was a product of the Son's imagination. We are products of the Son's work. There is this partnership between Father, Son, and Holy Spirit that brought us together in this planet Earth, in this part of planet Earth, Asia, here in the Philippines, and particularly here in Quezon City, and particularly here in this room. It was because of the love of the Father. It was the love of the Father upon His Son that brought us here. And yet, siyempre isipin mo, paano yung John chapter 3, verse 16, "For God so loved the world that He gave His only begotten Son, so that whoever believes in Him should not perish, but have eternal life." Precisely because the love of the Father extends to us through His Son. Sinabi rin sa John na, "As the Father loves me," Jesus Christ, "so has the Father loved you." So, there is something that is happening that we cannot even begin to understand until we become parents. Na papalang itong mga bata na ito na makukulit, pasaway, pabebe, ito ba yung mga words na nagamit these days, nakaka-stress. As a parent, you wonder how they will grow up. Pero, you know, our own parents wondered how we will grow up to become what we are today. Our parents are like us, helpless human beings. But something happened, and that something that happened na hindi nga ma-define ng dictionary kung feeling ba or decision is love. Sabi nila, love is a feeling. Sabi naman ang iba, love is a decision. Ano nga ba talaga? Kaya isagutin natin, God is love. So, if you will see, feel, taste, embrace the invisible qualities of God, perhaps that is love. We were loveless until love was given us by the Father through His Son. Kaya nga, sinabi na when we were sinners, God loved us so much, but that He gave His Son to die for us. As parents, we are willing to give up our lives for our own children. Pag may mga sakit nga yung mga maliliit nating anak, di ba? Pag nakikita natin nagsasuffer sila nung maliliit pa sila, let's say nakagat ng dengue mosquito, ano ba yun na Aedes aegypti, sabi doon sa libro ng isang anak. O kaya nagkaroon ang kaso. Ano pa ba yung mga magalang sakit? Kanina may kausap ako, sakit doon ng anak niya, parang hand and mouth disease. Sabi ko, parang foot and mouth disease yata ng animal yun ah. Pero there's such a thing as this disease na children acquire and walang gamot. Vitamins lang. And yet, that is the small child is asked by the school to stay in his or her home for 1 week. Ah, gano'n ka-serious yung mga yung sakit na ito. I think some of the teachers, our young teachers, can verify na meron ganitong sakit. So, as parents, we sometimes want to take the place of our own child. Kung nakikita natin silang na i-dextros na, tapos medyo habang tinutusok-tusok yung karayong, may hindi makita-kita yung ugat. Kalachamba na yung nurse. Doon din dumating yung head nurse na kalachamba rin. Mukhang ang dami ng tusok ng anak ko ah. Dumating na yung resident nurse na kalachamba rin. Kasi meron mga bata ng ugat talaga, maliliit. Hindi ko talaga makikita. Yung palang solusyon ay gagamit po tayo ng karayong na maliit na maliit na maliit. Dapat ninyo ginamit yun nung kauna-unahan pa para hindi na tayo nag-trial and error. So as parents, masakit when we find these little children suffering. And this was what Paul was also feeling. Was also thinking when he was informed by Epaphras, ito pong isang taga-Colosse, na may nangyayari dun sa Colossian church. And therefore, as a spiritual parent, Paul wanted to remind the people, the believers in Colossae, of what is important. And part of that is this verse. na pagbinasa nga natin, already gives us a lot of ideas, a lot of points about who God is, what God has for us, and His intentions for us. Who God is, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit. Anong intention niya sa atin? To transfer us from the kingdom of darkness to the kingdom of light. And anong motivation for that to happen? None other than love. Ngayon, ang tanong, paano natin i-apply ito bilang mga parents? Sometimes, we feel powerless. Paano ko ba pwede lang pilitin yung mga bata na, oh, maging believer ka para tapos na ang aking problema. And magpabaptize ka na, tanggapin mo na yung Holy Spirit, magpastor ka na, o magpastora ka na as a parent, tapos na ang aking problema. Pero hindi ganun kadali. And I'm sure, even our spiritual parents here, our leaders, our pastors, wants all of us to grow up and to mature. Kaya pinagdadala na tayo ng notebook. Pwede maisulat-sulat niya yung message. Kasi we look forward to the day na kayo naman ang nagsasalita dito. Kung hindi naman, kayo ang nagsasalita sa labas ng silid-aralan na ito, nitong ating place of worship. Because we need to send people out. Para bang mga batang maliliit tayo na unless we had parents who would not mature physically, we will not mature emotionally. And even for us believers, ang hope natin is that our children will mature spiritually. So how do we apply this? There are three applications that as spiritual parents and even for us natural parents that we can get into. One, live like Jesus. Mabuhay tayo ng kaparehas ni Jesus Christ. We do this by realizing that our faith, the faith of Jesus Christ, is the beginning and the ending of all things. Instead of man-made rules, instead of man-made traditions, instead of man-made technology, the beginning and the end of our faith in Jesus Christ, but most importantly, Jesus Christ who lives in us, and therefore we having the faith of Jesus Christ is Jesus Christ. So live like Jesus Christ. Paano po tayo mabubuhay like Jesus Christ? Paano mga maliliit na bata? Paano po sila nabubuhay? Ano po yung unang concern ng mga parents? That they get food. Okay, kung hindi natin na if we feed them nothing, sabi nga nung isang nag-share sa amin, if you feed the children nothing, they will die. Parang obvious yun, ano? Eh tayo po kaya, if we are not fed spiritually, we will also die spiritually. So saan po natin kinukuha yung ating spiritual nourishment? Kami po dito ay mga instruments po lamang. Hindi po namin in-invento itong mga sinasabi po namin sa inyo. This all came from this love letter that we call the Holy Bible. Dito po nanggagaling ating spiritual nourishment. And one way that we can live like Jesus Christ is beginning today. Look at the Bible this way. The Old Testament is Jesus Christ predicted. The Gospels, meaning the book or the letter, is it a letter or a book? Matthew, Mark, Luke, and John is Jesus Christ shown or revealed. And then we find the Acts, the book of Acts. Acts is Jesus Christ preach. And then the epistles, mga letters po ni John, ni Peter, ni James. This is Jesus Christ explained. And then we go to Revelations. This is Jesus Christ expected. So, I hope na hindi lang nadala kayong notebook, nadala ng ballpen, but this time around, I hope you will bring your Bibles with you. Because there, in the Bible, again, ulitin ko lang, you will find in the Old Testament, Jesus predicted. In the Gospels, Jesus Christ revealed. In the Acts, Jesus Christ preached. In the Epistles, Jesus Christ explained. And in Revelations, Jesus Christ expected. Kung magpo-focus lang po tayo doon sa Jesus Christ predicted, meaning the Old Testament, then ang tendency natin is to focus on rules and regulations. Kasi nakalagay naman doon, no? All Ten Commandments. So, kung hindi ka pa kontento sa Ten Commandments, kakas sa mga scholars, 630 misquotes. Meaning, mga additional rules and regulations that you need to follow. Eh, kasi nakalagay nga sa Old Testament eh. So, do we follow these rules and regulations? Like what was happening here in Colossians? The Colossi Church was being infiltrated by false teachers who were telling the Gentiles, look, for you to be saved, you need to follow the Ten Commandments. You need to become like a Jew. You need to be circumcised. You need to follow food laws. You need to keep the Sabbath. You need to keep the holidays. And this was what Paul was talking about or telling against, na you don't need to follow these rules because we have Jesus Christ who was predicted. And now the apostles were beginning to write Jesus Christ as revealed. Kaya nga po sinulat na yung Matthew, yung Mark, yung Luke, yung John. Kasi kulang yung Old Testament. That's only about Jesus Christ predicted. Now we need to reveal Jesus Christ to you. So read the Gospels. Now we need to explain, or we need to invite you, to get you to participate in being able to tell the good news about Jesus Christ, of Jesus Christ. Therefore, read the book of Acts, because this is where Jesus Christ is preached. This is where we find how Jesus Christ was preached. This is how we find brothers and sisters loving one another so that in the process when people see the love in the church, then they are attracted. Because that's one way Jesus Christ is preached, that there should be love among the believers. But then you say, hindi ko talaga maintindihan. O sige, di basahin mo yung mga letters, yung epistles, because there we will find Jesus Christ explained. Pagtsagaan nyo lang po. Basahin nyo ng makaisang beses, dalawa, tatlo, ilang kaya? 100. Pag medyo nagsawa na kayo sa pagbabasa ng mga letters, kumuha kayo ng recording. One way that you can really appreciate the letters is when you hear it from a recording. O kaya kung husband ka, o sabi mo si Mrs., Mrs., pwede mong basahin mo sa akin yung Colossians. Walang naman to, mga 15 minutes siguro basahan. Kaya lang sabihin ng wife. Kaya favorite verse ko lang yan, husbands, love your wives and do not be harsh with them. Tapos. Eh hindi po yun ang book of Colossians. Part naman ang book of Colossians. Eh sabihin naman ng mister, ako naman ang babasa sa'yo ah. Sabi dito sa book of Colossians, wives, submit your husbands as is fitting in the Lord. May nagtatalo-talo na. Pati mga bata, nakisali na rin. Sabi ng mga anak, fathers, do not embitter your children or they will become discouraged. Ay, sabi naman ng tatay, children, obey your parents in everything for this pleases the Lord. So, at the surface, sometimes paborito kong i-preach ito kasi parang mga rules and regulations. Pero what is behind it is the love of the Father towards His Son. Now, the only way we can do these things is if there is love. And so, binasa na natin yung Bible. So, what do we do now? Ganun na lang ba? Binasa na lang natin. Sometimes, the way to learn is sabi nga, for you to understand something, you have to obey first. And second point that I want to give, as far as application is concerned, kanina, first point, live like Jesus. Second point is show them Jesus. Show them Jesus. Ipakita natin si Jesus. And when we do this, how do we do it? In the verses or the instances that I cited about wives, about husbands, about children, and about fathers, this is how to do it. It is the Lord Christ you are serving. So, wives, when you submit to your husbands, it is the Lord Jesus Christ that you are showing and that you are serving. Hindi yung para bang ba't ganun yung Bible, wala na akong ka-pride-pride bilang wife, sunod na lang ba ako ng sunod? No, when you suffer, just in case you have an unbelieving husband, you're showing that unbelieving husband Jesus Christ. And you're beginning to serve Jesus Christ because by doing so, you are ministering to that husband. And if you have children, and if the husband decides to stay with you and not to disassociate with you, your children are blessed. They are sanctified. They are holy. Because you, as a believer, is already holy. Kaya nga, sinabi rin naman dun sa husband, so love your wives and do not be harsh with them. Again, filter it in the context of it is Jesus Christ that you are serving when you love your wife. Sabi, di ba? Husbands, let not your prayers be hindered because you have to treat the wife, a weaker vessel, made in the image of God, pero with a different role, takot sa ipis, takot sa daga, takot sa spider, o kayong mga husbands, kayong pumatay ng ipis, ng daga, ng spider. Again, children, when you obey your parents, do this in the context of serving Jesus Christ. It is Jesus Christ that you are serving, that you are obeying. So, when the children obey, they're also to honor their parents. Of course, darating ang time, pag medyo naging teenager na, nagiging young adult na, nagiging adult na, children, you don't need to obey your parents. But you need to honor them still. Because God created you in such a way that you will have also your own freedom when the time comes to choose your profession, to choose whom you will marry, to choose whom you will live. Ang hirap nung kayong mga children, eh, kayo pinag-decide niyo pa rin yung mga parents niyo ng mga, what, 80 years old na, na siya pipili ng profession niyo, ng mapapangasawa niyo, hindi ganun po. We are to grow with rights and responsibilities that Jesus Christ is giving all of us. Pero for this to happen, again, we need the fathers. The fathers who give the identity to the children. Fathers, you need to be telling your sons, you're a man, you have what it takes. And fathers, you need to be telling your daughters, you're beautiful, you are worth fighting for. Hinihintay po ng mga children to. Eh wala, sasabihin ng mga fathers sometimes, baka lang, magtatap ka sa kindergarten school mo ah. Tap nga sa kindergarten. Kailangan tap ka rin doon sa elementary, sa high school, sa college, sa master's, sa doctorate. Ayun, nag-tap na nga sa lahat. E kasi hindi naman nakilala si Jesus Christ. So what's the use? The other fathers, when we love our children, when we do not become harsh to them, when we do not embitter them, again, this is our way of serving Jesus Christ. It is the Lord Jesus Christ that we are serving when we are not harsh to our children. So, ano pa ang kulang? What more is needed? A third point. Again, in first point, mayroong gawin, pero basahin na lang natin ang Bible in the context of Jesus Christ predicted, revealed, which ang mga kalalakihan dito, I look forward na after me, mas marami nang mag-preach. And then Jesus Christ explained, and then Jesus Christ expected. We're waiting for Jesus Christ to come again. And then, yung second point is, show them Jesus. Ang tanong, how can you show something that you have not shown, na hindi pinakita sa inyo? How can you give something that was not given to you? So the third point is, give them Jesus. Live like Jesus, show them Jesus, give them Jesus. And ito nga yung ginawa ni Epaphras, who's being mentioned here in the letter to the Colossians. Sabi ni Paul, your faith in Christ Jesus, the gospel you learned from Epaphras. Sino po si Epaphras? Pag binasa niyo po dito sa mga last few verses ng Colossians, dito sa chapter 4, this is how Paul recognized Epaphras, our dear fellow servant, a faithful minister of Christ on our or on Paul's behalf. He told Paul of the Colossians' love in the Spirit, a servant of Jesus Christ, always wrestling in prayer for you, working hard for you. Ito po si Epaphras. Short of giving them Jesus Christ, he was also shepherding, he was also ministering, he was also praying for the Colossian church. Give them Jesus. It's not enough that we just share, oh, ito si Jesus Christ, oh, maniwala ka sa Kanya, oh, save ka na, oh, believer ka na, oh, sige, bye-bye. We need to give Jesus Christ not only as Savior, but as Lord. We need to help people learn to love Jesus Christ by following Jesus Christ. If you love me, you will follow me. Yung po'y sinabi ni Jesus Christ. And so, my dear brothers and sisters, marami pa po tayong matututuhan dito sa letter to the Colossians Church. I would encourage you to read this. Napakarami po. Jesus Christ is explained in this letter. Pag binasa niyo po dito sa mga sumunod po na mga verses. Medyo patikim lang kasi parang, I'm beginning to see the letter to the Colossians as one of my favorite letters. Because here, the supremacy of Jesus Christ is explained. Pag binasa niyo po yung first itong verse na ito, yung sumunod pa dito sa 1 Corinthians chapter 13, di ba nandun yung 14? Siyempre, logical naman, 13, 14, 15. Eh, pasahin nyo na lang yung 13, yung 14, saka 15, this is what you will read. In whom we have redemption, the forgiveness of sins. He is the image of the invisible God, the firstborn over all creation. Siksik. Kasi ganun po magsulat si Paul. In fact, when you read it in Greek, yung isang passage po dito, yung isang paragraph dito na it seems to be divided into several sentences, is just one sentence in the Greek. In that one sentence, halo-halo dyan. nandiyan nagte-Thanksgiving tayo, nandiyan iniisip natin yung how we are going to relate to Jesus Christ, nandiyan yung kasino si Jesus Christ. It is so rich with so many ways that Jesus Christ is explained. Basahin nyo na lang po. And so in conclusion, my brothers and sisters, napaka-importante po na hindi lang tayo maging magkakapatid sa salita o sa gawa, but that also we become spiritual brothers and sisters. Kung meron po dito na hindi pa nakatanggap kay Jesus Christ as Savior and Lord, then I sort of beg you, I sort of ask you, I sort of invite you to accept Jesus Christ as Savior and Lord. And then ang promise niya po, magkakaroon ng regeneration. You will be given a new life. You will be given a spiritual life. Right now, tayo po na, nung there was a time na hindi pa po tayo mga believers, the life that we only had was physical and emotional or soul. But nung tinanggap po natin si Jesus Christ as Savior and Lord, yung pong spirit in us became alive. We were given a spirit life. Naging kompleto po tayo as physical, soul, and spirit. But then, kanino makikipag-usap itong spirit na ito? Walang iba kundi sa Holy Spirit. So when we believe, when we manifested our belief through baptism, and through the laying of hands, we receive the Holy Spirit upang mangusap po sa ating bagong spirit. Hindi na yung old spirit. Yung old spirit, actually, yung old spirit, patay. But what we have is an old man, a human nature, na pilit na inaagaw ang ating attention. Still have this physical body that is tempting us, that Satan is using to tempt us to commit sin. But thanks be to God, that the time will come when you will be given a glorified body na wala na yung hindi na matetempt ni Satan. But for the meantime, we struggle, we discipline ourselves so that we do not follow the ways and means of the flesh, of the human body, but rather we begin to follow the Spirit. Sinasabi po ng ating Spirit as the Holy Spirit guides us to learn more and more about Jesus Christ. So in a simple prayer, pwede po natin tanggapin si Jesus Christ as Savior and Lord. Ito po yung pakikipag-usap between God the Father and you, kung meron po dito na hindi pa nakatanggap sa kanya. Ngayon, kung natanggap niya na po siya, hindi naman nyo kailangan tanggapin siya ng paulit-ulit. Misa lang po natin tinatanggap si Jesus Christ as Savior and Lord. Pero ang paulit-ulit po is that we need to follow Jesus Christ again and again by living like Jesus, by showing Jesus Christ, and by giving Jesus Christ. Meron rin po tayong right and responsibility to be able to share the good news. Ano po yung good news? The crucifixion, the resurrection, and the ascension of Jesus Christ. Na tayo rin po were crucified, tayo rin po were resurrected, tayo rin po are now seated at the right hand of the Father in a spiritual sense, because our spirit is now with the Father, with the Son, and the Holy Spirit. So, hindi lang po tayo mga believers, we're also to become fellow workers. And so, my fellow workers, for the kingdom of God, fellow spiritual parents, and fellow natural parents with little children, na may responsibility po. Again, ulitin ko lang po, yung three applications? To live like Jesus Christ, to show them and to give them. Parents, haunting tip. To live like Jesus Christ is like to be crucified before your children. Okay, kung dati hindi ka naghuhugas ng plato, nawalan kayo ng kasambahay, maghugas-hugas ka na ng kontrato. Kung ikaw ay husband. Okay? Kung dating na hindi ka marunong mag-drive, no, ay nawalan kayo ng driver. Kung mga misis, mag-aaral na rin kayo mag-drive. Diba? Pag napunta yung mga couples sa US, eh, magugulat kayo. Mas mabilis pang magtaka mo ng kotse yung mga misis kaya sa mga mister. Paano? Puro highway naman doon. And so, live like Jesus. To show Jesus Christ, meaning, ito, yung practice natin ng love. Love is patient, love is kind. Diba sabi nga, love is not easily angered. Love does not keep a record of wrongs as parents. Ganun rin pong gawin nyo. And then, last but not the least, give them Jesus. As early as possible, kahit bata pa yan. That's why nga, we bring them to church. We ask them to be prayed for or to be offered to God through the blessing of little children. That's one way we are able to give them Jesus Christ as early as possible. And so when we do this, we are practicing kingdom parenting. Again, the title of the message is Kingdom Parenting, How by Living Like Jesus, Showing Them Jesus, and Giving Them Jesus. Pwede pong tumayo tayong lahat, and let's pray. Let's pray. Our Father in Heaven, we stand before you this morning. Ama, if there is anything that can be remembered about this message, ito lang po ang tulungan nyo kami to be able to realize and understand. It is to live like Jesus, show them Jesus, give them Jesus. Father, turuan mo po kami how we will go about this in our respective individual lives. And then Father, also kausapin niyo po kami individually to be able to apply these principles, especially with regards to the little children na wala pong kamalay-malay, na kailangan po silang ma-rescue, kailangan po nilang matuto how to live in a kingdom with love, and to be able to realize yung redemption po na ginawa ni Jesus Christ on the cross for the forgiveness of all sins. Hindi po maiwasan na magkasakitan, na magkasala, and thankfully, Father, through Jesus Christ, napapatawad niyo po ang lahat ng past, present, and future hurts that were done by parents upon their children and children upon their parents. But more so, Father, as a spiritual body, we are also given the task of being able to share the good news. Kaya i-bless niyo po ang bawat isa po sa amin na tumanggap na kay Jesus Christ as Savior and Lord, na mangaral rin po, na ma-explain rin po, and matulungan po ang lahat na mag-expect kay Jesus Christ sa kanyang pong muling pagdating. Father God, in a few moments, maybe in a few moments of silence, kausapin niyo po ang bawat isa. I'm requesting po yung worship team to just play some instrumental music for 1 minute. Worship team, if you can play an instrumental music for 1 minute and that will allow each one of us to meditate on these applications, live like Jesus, show them Jesus, give them Jesus. Father, we stand before you today. Kausapin niyo po, bawat isa po sa amin. Sa amin pong nakatayo na gusto naman po, pwede naman pong po, but for 1 minute, we just stand before you and we want to hear your voice just for 1 minute. And then we will proceed with singing praises and worship.